In the following video, I want to show you how we create clean plates for the movie, because there have been actually quite a bit of these shots where we had to remove stuff from the footage to create something that doesn't have objects in the background. So I want to quickly show you how we did that. So first of all, here's the original shot, and you can see it's me and Jeremy holding broomsticks to hold the actor so that this moment of releasing, when the robot is releasing him, that this looks a bit more believable, so that he's actually reacting to something. So that's why, well, we have been putting these broomsticks against him, but of course we have to be removed, and also the broomsticks. So, and for that we needed a clean plate. Just we needed one in 1-2A, which I've showed you in a different video, and I want to show you how we did that. So first of all, maybe a quick camera track. I think maybe up to maybe to make it a bit faster, up to here, that should be long enough. So first track everything with this very simple tripod solve. So maybe track this thing, oops, then something in the background, or maybe here, even though it's probably moving, but I think it's good enough. And then something up here. So three or four markers should be good enough. Okay, so that should be good enough to make a tripod solve. So tripod motion, Shift S, and it's a decent solve error, even though we didn't even set the camera data yet. So maybe I can quickly do that. So this is 7.24.33, and the focal length, I don't know, maybe 50 or 35. Doesn't matter, let's use 50. Okay, so this is now the solve. I go right away to the 3D viewport, select the camera, split this view, bring up the properties, go to the constraints, set the camera solver constraint, and then go to top view, and I make this a bit faster now. So just place that over here so that we now have this. So you can see the camera is just rotating a little bit. And now also zero to look through the camera, then go down here, set the footage as the background. So we've got that, then we can delete the cube right away. And anything that we now put in the background will stick to the footage because the camera is moving in the right way. So we can add a plane, rotate that 90 degrees, and move it up and move it so that it matches the camera. Okay, just roughly. And I made it a bit bigger so that it fills up the entire view because the camera is rotating just a bit, so that should be fine. And now the thing is, I want to create a clean plate. So something from the footage should be projected onto this plane so that we can render that plane and then use it as a composite. And to do that, first of all, I also need a UV image editor, and then go to edit mode. And first of all, because I'm going to use camera projection, I'm subdividing that, Control R, then select everything, W, subdivide, and do that a couple of times so that we have a lot of resolution, because otherwise camera projection would lead to problems. Now if you have a look in the object data, you can go to UV maps, and if I press U and unwrap that, now we have a UV map. So it's filling up the image nicely, so I can now create a 2K image, 2048 by 2000, or actually maybe make it like this, 48. And then the important things, because we're dealing here with OpenEXR, you have to make it 32-bit float, otherwise it wouldn't work. So this is now our clean plate, and I want to paint on that. But before I can do that, first I have to project the image sequence that you see here onto this plane. And for that I want to use a second UV map. So I click on this little plus sign, and then name that project. And you don't need to do anything, you just have to have this layer. So the next step is to go to the modifiers and then add the UV project modifier, set it to the correct projection map, then set the correct aspect ratio, and you can also just fill in the dimensions of the movie, so 1920 by 1012. This is our footage dimensions, and then the projector is of course our camera. So now that is working, and to be able to see that, first of all, I'm going to create a new object, but just to make it shadeless. I'm not doing anything else with that. So now I have to put the image sequence onto that. Unfortunately, we cannot use the movie clip, which would be the easiest thing. So I have to divide that so that we still have the movie clip open like that. Okay, so here's the movie clip editor. And here I'm going to open up a second UV image editor. Go to the edit mode and then make sure that you have the project UV map active. Also make sure that you have one active face, otherwise it will also for some reasons not work. It's a little bit crappy, so you always have to have an active face, otherwise this won't work. So next step is to open up the sequence. So this is the footage that we are using. So I just select the first frame, open the image, and then go to the properties here and then switch it from a single image to image sequence. Then make sure that you are using the correct frame range. So the action here that is happening is between these frames. So last frame could be 2540 and enable auto refresh. So this now more or less matches if you switch one frame. Okay, so this matches more or less. The problem is it doesn't match exactly. And I still don't know why that happens. The start frame and offset stuff in Blender is a bit annoying. I assume it has to do with the fact that the sequence starts on frame zero and the movie clip editor and the image editor somehow behave differently. So the frame that you see here and the frame that you see here are not matching. And I figured that if you set the start frame to 2, then it will match. So if you do that currently, if your sequence starts at 0, you have to make sure that you have the right start frame. In this case, this would be 2. At least that's working here in this case. You can also check if that really works by using the background images. So these are already set up, but you don't see them yet. And for that, you can also switch from back to front. So now they are, instead of being in the background, they are always in the foreground. So now if you would set the viewport so that you can actually see what's projected onto the plane, you can see if the frames really match. Now to do that, you can go to display and then enable textured solid, because then Blender will display the frame that is projected currently onto the footage. Okay, so now if I go through the shots, you can see that it is working. Sometimes there seem to be some updating issues. I assume that is also something to do with my graphics card. But overall, this seems to be working nicely. Now, the background image of the camera images are at 50%. So if you disable them, this is now only displaying what is shown on the object itself. If you set it to opacity 1, this is now the camera sequence, so this is lining up perfectly. Okay, so this is great, and we can use that for texture painting. And the way to do that is now, first of all, make sure that you have the clean plate up here, and that the most important thing is that you keep the sequence here. Now, if I would switch on my object, maybe in edit mode, back to the to this UV map, it would also switch the display in the UV image editor. But you can pin that, so no matter what context you choose, this will always display the sequence, which is important so that it does update the movie. Then up here, I want to see the clean plate. So for that, I can now switch to the UV map. Go to edit mode, it will display the clean plate. I also pin that so that I always see that. And here you can see it's still displaying that. So that's nice. And now I switch from edit mode to texture paint, bring up my sidebar. Then since I'm still on this one frame, I can go full screen. And when I update the footage, I will have to switch again. Anyway, now I switch from brush to clone. set the strength to 1, maybe disable the pressure sensitivity, and then in projection paint, enable clone, and then you have to set the correct layer. So currently it would use the input from UV map, but of course we want to paint from the projected map. So I go to project, and now if you paint here, you actually paint what is currently being projected onto the other plane. So now I can fill up this entire frame very quickly without caring about if it really is clean or not. So first, just to have the image here. And then after that, I can switch to frames where you don't see me and Jeremy and then paint that onto the image. And because the camera is moving with the footage, because it is projecting, it should fit pretty well to the background content of the frame. Okay, so to make the video sequence that we are painting onto the mesh also update, we have to go out of full screen mode. But now I can switch to one frame where you only see the clean background. Then make sure that everything's really updated. And then I can go full screen again. And now if you paint here, I'm actually painting a clean plate. And if you look here, you can see what I'm painting on. So I'm really painting on the clean plate. So magically, I'm removing myself and the other guy and the other broomstick. And then of course, with F, you can change the brush size to have a bit more control, and then carefully painting and creating a clean plate. Now, changing the opacity, you can use that to see what is on the frame and what is projected. So I can see here, this area is the hairline, and here this is what I've painted before. So if I now use that, I can get rid of the hair. And that's how we cleaned up all the plates on the bridge. And that is very nice, because you're actually using the original footage and same noise pattern and everything. So that's really, really nice. Just would be nice if you could do it full screen all the time, so that you don't have to wait for the screen to update. But still, I think you get the idea. So that was a very straightforward workflow, and it was quite easy to get rid of all the stuff. And then in the end, don't forget to save the image. So image and then save as image. I'll just save it here. The important thing is that you set the correct format, because remember, we have been painting a 32-bit float image. So we have to set it from PNG to OpenEXR. In the case that you have an alpha channel, you of course have to also set that. In our case, we don't need it. We also don't need to have 32-bit float. It's enough if you save that as half float, at least in our case, because the raw footage, we have been saved that as 16-bit instead of 32-bit for footage. I think that is good enough. So float point, save that image, and then use it in the composite. And if you want to know how we did that, you can open up the walkthrough of 5.6a. There I'm going to show you how we use that.